What's up, everybody? It's Chris from Top Notch Sports, and here's my first tutorial video. Yesterday, I posted a video of me shooting, just so you could see my mechanics, and you could, you know, make comments on that. Check that one out. But me, I have my own take on how to shoot a jump shot. Now, everyone likes to teach the elbow. You know, that straight, that L, right? Me, I don't really prefer that. I prefer whatever works for you. Some guys, they shoot with kind of like a semi-L. Some guys, they got it up here, behind their head, at the head. Some guys, you know, like Shane Battier, maybe they kind of shoot like this. To me, whatever's comfortable, but you got to hold it around the head, or else you're going to get blocked as you advance to when guys are longer, quicker, just, you know, in general, more skilled. You can't shoot like this anymore. You gotta have it at least around your head. Knees. You can't be too low, but you gotta have some flexion in your knees. Biggest thing is, you get the ball, you gotta be kinda in that position or at least close and you can go down quick. And if you look at most players, right, they'll get it and they dip the ball a little bit. That's perfectly fine. You don't have to catch it and bring it right up. No. You don't have to bring it right up. There's no potential energy. Dip it a little bit. That's fine. Knees bent. Not too much, but good flexion. So then after that is the hop. Now, people say, oh, you know, release right before you hit the apex of your jump, or when you hit the apex of your jump. Completely disagree. Me, don't think about when you release it when you jump. Just get it. You jump, you shoot, one motion. And the biggest thing at the end is the follow through. Some guys say, oh, you know, up high. Me, I say out. That's just consistency. Stick your hand in the basket. Out. Out. Remember that. If you remember that, you're going to be a better shooter, regardless of what you do with your lower body. If, you know, because at the end of the day, the ball is going to go where you direct it, right? So it's one motion, one fluid motion. You catch, right? You dip the ball a little bit. You got your knees. One motion, just one fluid hop. Don't think about releasing it when you hit the top of the jump. Don't think about that. I used to do that, and I'm a much better shooter now. So I'll just show you what it looks like. Okay, that wasn't the best example. Hopefully I hit this one. Okay, so that's the jump shot. Now here's the next thing I want to get to. The next thing I want to get to is driving to the hoop, because that's a big problem. How do you get past defenders that are stronger, they're longer? Well, really, besides all the crossover behind the back, you know, those fancy Kyrie Irving type of moves, or Allen Iverson crossovers, they're all great, they work. But at the end of the day, you gotta get leverage under your defender. And use this arm to protect the ball. Don't push with it, but use it as an extra force, as basically a battering ram. That will help you fight off contact, and so that if defenders reach in for that ball and they're gonna hit your arm, foul. You'll have them fouling out in the second quarter. Guys that are extra aggressive and like to reach. So that's the one thing. You can't play straight legged in this game. You want to beat somebody, you got to get leverage. Whether you're 6'8", you're 6'2", or you're 5'8". No matter what height, tall, short, medium height, whatever, you got to get lower than your defender. That's the biggest thing. Okay, so that's just getting by your defender. Now, when you get there to the big man, don't try to always. And this is the same thing. Don't always try to out-jump the guy trying to block your shot. Because even a guy that's the same size, you maybe even shorter, could just jump up and block it. What I find to be the best, and this is personal, but I noticed that NBA players do this, just go like you're doing a normal layup in warm-ups. Don't change your shot. Don't fade away. You're not going to get a call by fading away. Go up. Normal layup. Your two steps, everything how you do it in the warm-ups, do it, but with obviously extra intensity, extra adrenaline. Do that, and you'll get calls, and you'll finish. Because at the end of the day, if you're going like this, and you're both two people are moving, the foul's going to be on the defender if he hits you. Or a big man, they're going to try to reach over, and once the refs see those guys reaching over, it's a foul. So I'm going to just show you how I do it. I'm going to do a lefty layup, and then a righty layup. Okay, so that's lefty. Here's right. Okay, so that's how to drive, in my opinion, how to drive and shoot. You do those two basic things, then you could expand your game. Then you could add a Euro step. Then you could add a fake and finish. Then you could, do your pull-up jump shots. You could do your step-back fadeaway jump shots. But you have to have the basic premise of how to shoot the ball with consistent mechanics, right? And how to get to the hoop consistently and draw fouls, get yourself to the free throw line, and, not be complaining, oh, he fouled me, when you're fading away from the basket. You got to go strong. You got to go straight up. Okay, then you're going to get the call and probably learn to finish. So if you like this video, subscribe to my channel. I'm sorry. Subscribe to my channel. Check out my other videos, and I'm going to have more coming. Thanks a lot for watching.